Mesut olduğu Kamil, Mirza ise Mesut olduğu Kamil, Mirza ise Mesut olduğu Kamil, Slav Iisusu Hristu.
I think it's the time we have put a piece together for the press release and with our demands. I think it's a time that I will read something out, so it does make sense why we are here today. And I also want to make sure and clear, when the last Ukrainian soldier falls, Putin will come for you, ladies and gentlemen. Because again, Ukraine now stands alone for the whole democratic world. And Putin and the Russian army bombarding Ukraine in all different directions from the air. Northeastern Ukraine and the western as well. How long the world will be silent? We silenced this and witnessed for 8 years. So, the action needs to be done now. Ukraine is fighting for the future of democracy. Ukraine is fighting for the freedom and human dignity. Russia is a revisionist power fighting for the imperial ambitions of a sick man and so sick human-hating system. We must stop the war at the heart of Europe. Putin will stop only where he is stopped by all of us. We are grateful for all the UK and international support Ukraine is receiving, but more needs to be done to stop the invasion, and now is bombarding. The sanction introduced, it's very weak and failed to deter this renewed invasion. Putin hasn't ever started feeling any pain so far. He is actually in profit from his aggression, with spiking oil and gas prices, bringing windfall profits for Gazprom and Rosneft. The West needs to finally wake up and establish an anti-Putin coalition. United Kingdom, Ukraine's strategic partner and long-standing friend, should push for establishment of no-fight zone for Russian aircraft over Ukraine by NATO. Help Ukraine with the more weapons, supply and troops if officially deployment not possible. Announce creation of voluntary battalions. Ukraine legislation allows foreign citizens to join Ukrainian armed forces. Introduce Iran-North Korea-style sanctions against Russia and block Putin dirty money in the UK, dirty money invested in newspapers, in mansions, they are all in UK banks. Maybe it's the time to stop. Stop right now. Seize assets of Russian oligarchs, Russian high-ranking officials and all MPs who voted for the recognition of occupied territories of Ukraine and their family members, and use the money to help Ukraine. Where possible, arrest Russian oligarchs, block Russian companies owned directly or indirectly by the Russian state, Russian oligarchs or their family members from raising capital on London financial markets. Forbid all institutional investors and pension funds from buying Russian assets. We call everyone who values freedom, democracy, and human dignity to stand up against a totalitarian regime seeking to renew Europe's borders by joining us in this, I do not know what we're going to fight for. But we will resist! Ukraine will resist! Ukraine! devastating sanctions on Russia now, including SWIFT. Please, including SWIFT. Full isolation of Russia by voting on all formats, weapons, equipment for Ukraine. We've got airstrikes at the moment. Financial assistance and humanitarian assistance. Thank you. Slava Ukraini!
Slava!
I think it's probably the time to submit to Kuchale. Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Everybody, my name is Edward Lucas. I've been writing about security and the threat in Russia since the 1990s. But first of all, dear colleagues in the press, please move away from this poster. We need people for driving past to see it. So I'm asking all the people who are standing here in front of the poster, please move out of the way. You can talk from over there, you can talk from over there, you can talk from over there. Please, all of you, ladies and gentlemen with the tripod, gentlemen with the camera, thanks very much. Can you move so we can see this magnificent poster? I'm really asking you, ladies and gentlemen, including the lady there with the tripod, please can you move out of the way so we can see the poster? We owe you such an apology, because this didn't come as a surprise. If it came as a surprise, then maybe it comes as a surprise in there, it maybe comes as a surprise in there, it may be a surprise in Brussels and Berlin and Paris and Washington DC, but it doesn't come as a surprise to people who are paying attention. And we were warned about this back in the 1990s. We were warned by Estonians, we were warned by Latvians, we were warned by Lithuanians, we were warned by Poles, we were warned by Ukrainians, we were even warned by Russians. My dear friends, people like Boris Nemtsov, now then, they were warning us even then, Russia is going in the wrong direction. Those old imperial chauvinist ghosts that we saw exemplified in the Soviet Union and Soviet imperialism, they haven't gone. They're still there. We saw it with the Karaganov factory, we saw it with Kutukov, the foreign minister. This is before some of us even were born, that we saw the threat and people didn't listen. There were warnings given by all those countries and they came. I saw them here In Downing Street, the Lithuanian leader returned to stands by us. They were patronized and belittled and ignored. They were told, you have post-traumatic stress disorder. You don't really understand Russia the way that we do. And so we missed a huge chance. We missed a chance to expand NATO, expand the EU, and bring more countries, including Ukraine, into the sphere of security and prosperity and legality and decency and freedom. And we could have done that. Nobody stopped us. There were no Russian tanks rolling down the streets of London saying, ignore Ukraine. There were no Russian tanks rolling down the streets of London saying, sell newspapers to Russian oligarchs, saying, sell football clubs to Russian oligarchs, and most of all, open your financial system and your political system to Russian dirty money. No, we didn't do that because someone made us. We did it because we were stupid and naive and complacent and above all, weak. We profited from all that Russian dirty money, and who paid the price? Well, you did. You paid it because you couldn't have the prosperity and security and dignity that you could have had inside the European Union, and most of all, you paid it in blood after 2014. 14,000 dead Ukrainians, the result of the West failure. And every one of them, not just a soul lost, but also every one of them leaving orphan children, spouses, parents, friends, neighbours and loved ones. That is an enormous debt. Bill paid by you, and it's due here. So it's the least we can do in the old, complacent, lazy, greedy West. But now, the 59th minute, the 59th second of the 59th minute of the 11th hour, that we finally do something. It's so long to do this. Where are you to start? Well, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a step. So let's start right now with the dirty money. Let's start right now with sending the arms to Ukraine so that Ukraine can defend itself. Let's start right now preparing for refugees. Let's start right now sending our Navy to the Black Sea, to the Baltic Sea. Let's start right now with every passport of diplomatic, and military, and financial, and economic, that we can put support Ukraine and support Russia. So thank you for your warning in so many years. And sorry from the bottom of our hearts that we did not listen when we could have.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes, and we did say this 8 years ago. Everything what you are saying now. I want also to emphasize about what Putin said. The Ukraine is not a sovereign country. I want to remind the whole world, Ukraine is a sovereign country, independent country. Ukraine has its own history. Ukraine has its own language. Ukraine has its own nation. Ukraine has its own territory. Ukraine has its own tradition. So, we are three independent countries. We're never gonna be part of Russia. Never. We are not part of Russia. So if they occupied back in 2014, it means nothing. Donetsk is Ukraine, Luhansk is Ukraine. Crimea is Ukraine. Putin, hands off Ukraine!
Putin, hands off Ukraine! Putin, hands off Ukraine! Putin, hands off Ukraine! Putin, hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
Putin,
hands off Ukraine!
And now maybe we can ask. UK, support Ukraine!
UK, support Ukraine!
UK, support Ukraine!
UK, support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine! UK, support Ukraine!
One more time! The world needs to wake up now and act immediately! Putin needs to be stopped! The world, democratic world, needs to say no! It's enough! Enough wars! Enough destroying different countries! Name how many countries he destroyed! Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war! Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war! Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
Stop Putin! Stop the war!
Stop Putin!
Stop the war!
I think Ukraine has passed its exam for democracy back in 2013, when we've chosen European direction. We are free people. We live in a free country, and it will never change. Slava Ukraini! And now, the West and democratic leaders, they can do more and act now. Immediately! Хлопці, нам треба вода з'їсти. Де бутелки з водою? Sorry. UK, support Ukraine!
UK, support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK,
support Ukraine!
UK
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 support Ukraine!
UK support Ukraine! the Putin front. Russian army at the moment killing civilians. They are entering Ukrainian territory, cities, invading from different directions. Again, what Russian soldiers are fighting for? Russian army needs to go home. Russian soldiers need to go back home. And Ukrainian soldiers.
He just feels like God, so I think we are trying to stop and save Ukraine and get help from other countries, from the West, UK, America, and other countries, because we need the support right now. Like right now, I think that we need to get support, such as military, planes, air defense systems, as well as troops, which they don't want to do.
Thank you very much. Not responsible for your safety.
What would your message be for our troops right now?
I would say that we should give troops, send troops right now to Ukraine, using planes, whatever. We are asking for this. We are trying to get help. Like, please, just help Ukraine. Save Ukraine. This war is not just this was our friend. We are the Soviet countries, such as Latvia, Estonia, and other countries. And one day it will definitely become the world's Scotland and America.
Thank you. really good to me. Well, so just one to me in English and then I'll ask you in Ukrainian.
Прийшлося нам за це понести. Але тут зараз хочу сказати, що це остаточно формується наша українська нація. Зараз ми всі повинні вистояти у цій війні. Кожен з нас, хто має рідні вдома, друзі, знайомих, підтримуйте їх. Підтримуємо наших підрітних молитвою, допомогою, щоб всі зберігали віру в те, що ми переможемо. Саме найперше в наш час – це потрібна віра. Віра в нашу перемогу. Тому що з нами є правда і з нами Бог. А де Бог, там є любов. А де є любов, там є перемога. Ніхто не може виступити проти Бога і перемогти Його. Путін переступив межу, він виступив проти добра. Але завжди Бога добро перемагало. Коли б це не було, все одно перемагало. І зараз добро переможе. Путін програє. Він це не усвідомлює, але це так. він уже програв. Починаючи цю війну, він уже програв. І ми маємо знати, що зараз ми вже з вами перемогли. Ми вже переможці, тому що ми стоїмо на дорозі добра. Ми є з Богом. Хочу сказати, що з нами Бог, з нами Україна, і ми переможемо. Слава Україні!
Героям слава!
Слава нації!
Перемога!
Україна!
Понад усе!
Okay, cool. All right, no worries.
Ukraine! Hands off now! More sanctions 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 now!
Dear Ukrainians, dear international community, we're here standing.
Okay, just text me your name and yeah, and
our fathers, sisters, brothers, sons, and daughters, and we are not giving up. And there are so many things that we can do. We can call our Ukrainian friends, we can call our neighbors, we can help them find the shelters, we can organize humanitarian help, we can speak up, we can speak to our Russian oppressors, to our neighbors, friends, we can call them all different names, but we still can speak to them and ask them to go in the streets. There are so many things, and we won't give up. I suggest we can start singing our national anthem, if you feel like this.
Yes. Ми не маємо оперного співака. Я так розумію, з України. Будь ласка, він і
французький. Друзі, якщо вам так само страшно, як мені, але дуже хочеться щось робити, давайте допомагати нашим українцям, давайте. Давайте допоможемо їм організувати зв'язок з нами. Давайте організуємо гуманітарну та військову допомогу. І давайте не ставатися. We're all standing here for the whole world. We're all standing here to prevent World War III. The future of Europe and the whole world depends on us, today, now and from now and on. We want more sanctions. We demand humanitarian help. We demand military help from our United Kingdom, who was one of the guarantors on the Budapest Memorandum. We demand it now. We demand NATO to help us. And we want it to happen right now. One more time again, devastating sanctions now on Russia, including SWIFT. We repeated this for 8 years. Switch off SWIFT!
Switch off SWIFT! Switch off SWIFT! Switch off SWIFT! Switch off SWIFT! Switch off SWIFT! Switch off SWIFT! Switch off SWIFT!
Stop! Yeah.
to act now. Ukrainian cities are being bombarded. How many more countries he has to destroy? Do you understand that he is evil? He is a sick man. You need to stop him.